Hello, Bea here, and welcome back to Environmental Science. What would be your initial guess? Do scientists have a better understanding of the surface of Mars or the bottom of the oceans on Earth? Would you believe me if I said we actually know more about the surface of Mars than the depths of our own oceans? There are many possible reasons for this discrepancy, but it's true. In this lesson, we are going to be introduced to the hydrosphere, or the areas of Earth that are made of water. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define the hydrosphere, identify and discuss the four oceans, discuss the water cycle, and how the hydrosphere is a closed system. In your notes, I want you to make a list of all of the places on Earth where you can find water. Go ahead and pause the video so that you don't feel rushed. On your list, you probably have the oceans, lakes, rivers, right? You may have rain, snow, and other precipitation too. What about glaciers? Or what about groundwater, which is the water just under the surface of the Earth? In fact, water covers over 70% of the Earth's surface, with the largest part of that, 96.5%, being the oceans. All of this water is part of the Earth's hydrosphere, where in our last lesson we learned that geo means earth or land. In today's lesson, hydro means water. Think back to our first lesson, when we talked about the spaceship Earth theory that described the planet like a spaceship, or a closed system with a finite number of resources. Do you remember what was meant by a closed system? A closed system is when resources are all kept within the system, but used in different ways. The hydrosphere is a closed system. The water on Earth does not leave the planet, but moves through the water cycle. In fact, water is the only substance to naturally exist in all three phases, solid, liquid, and gas, within the range of temperatures regularly found on Earth. At its most simplistic, the water cycle involves the sun heating surface water so that it becomes water vapor and evaporates into the sky. When the water vapor is in the sky, the cold temperatures of the atmosphere cause condensation and the vapor becomes a liquid in the clouds. Finally, precipitation occurs when the water molecules come together and the water falls from the sky as rain, snow, and sleet. This precipitation then becomes surface water, and the cycle is complete. In a later lesson in Unit 6, we will spend a lot more time going into the details of the water cycle. But for today, I want you to walk away remembering that it is a closed system of water moving through the hydrosphere. When you look at this map of the world's oceans, what do you notice? You may notice just how large the oceans are compared to the continental land masses, and you might even notice that all of the oceans are connected to each other. There are four oceans on Earth: the Pacific, the Atlantic, the Indian, and the Arctic oceans. The largest ocean by far is the Pacific Ocean. In fact, it is so large that it is often broken down into the North Pacific and South Pacific Oceans. The Pacific Ocean also has the deepest region, the Mariana Trench. The Mariana Trench is located near the Philippines and is deeper than Mount Everest is tall. While the Arctic Ocean has the most ice and therefore the coldest ocean, The Indian Ocean has the highest water temperatures. Finally, the Atlantic Ocean, named after the Greek god Atlas, is the ocean with the highest salinity, or concentration of salt in the water. It is also the most important driver of the weather on Earth. The fact that the oceans make up almost 70% of the surface of the Earth makes life on Earth possible. Without the ocean surface absorbing and storing so much heat from the sun, the planet would be too warm to support life. This, along with so many other reasons, is why it is important that scientists continue to study and learn more about the oceans of Earth. As we went through the lesson today, we were introduced to the hydrosphere as part of our introduction to environmental science. We will go into much more depth in our study of water in Unit 6. In our next lesson, we will continue our study of the spheres of Earth as we introduce the atmosphere. Until next time, remember, you're a force of nature, so keep sparking the changes that you want to see. Hey, hey.